Hey guys, so today I want to talk to you about Gizmocrate. I heard of it for the first time from Bryan Lanning on YouTube. I'll include the link to his channel down there. But yeah, he's awesome, along with his wife Missy and their little baby Oliver. They're the cutest little family ever. So anyways, this Gizmocrate is basically a box of a gadget and foodie discovery box, is what it says. Of warning, cool stuff. So, I'm going to see what's in here. So there's some tissue paper inside. It kind of looks like a little present. Just kind of clean. Okay, so first off, we have Sour Patch Watermelon. Sour Patch Kids in a long time, so I'll probably enjoy these. Now in Brian's box, you're supposed to get a little card that kind of says what's in the box and the information about it, but I don't have one of those, so I just have to wing it. So this is a Bluetooth remote shutter. Taking a better selfie. So basically, if you have anything with Bluetooth, specifically an Android device, then you can set it up somewhere and remotely take a picture of yourself or your friends. Basically, essentially a timer, except you get to be farther away from your phone. Yay! I don't know if I can actually use this because I don't think my phone has Bluetooth. I'm old school like that. So this is what that looks like. So yeah, apparently it's compatible for iPhone 5, iPhone 4, iPad 2 and 3, iPad mini, blah blah blah, Samsung Galaxy S2, S3, S4, etc., Note 1, Note 2, Note 3, a bunch of stuff. I can't remember what kind of my phone is, but I don't know, I have a feeling I might not be able to use this, but maybe my boyfriend can. So, moving on! Next I have another Bluetooth item. I'm not fancy enough for Bluetooth. Bluetooth wireless mini headset. I don't know, does my phone have Bluetooth? I'm gonna have to look into this now. But this is probably another thing that I wouldn't use. This is so disappointing so far. I was super excited about this. But anyways, what that looks like. Next we have... no idea what this is. It doesn't have any kind of labeling on it. I guess I'll open it. Oh, I think it's one of those sticky things that you can stick on your car and then you can stick your phone on there or something. I don't know, but it's just this little sticky thing. Plastic sleeve, and I have no idea what to do with it because there's no, like, this is what the wrapping looks like. Nothing on the back, and it just says Gizmocrate, a gadget and foodie discover box on the front. So, and there's one more item. Oh, sorry, there's two more items. Okay, the solar charger. Charges a range of devices via USB no matter where you are. So you stick your charger to any window by peeling off protective film, blah blah blah, plug the USB into your charging cable into it. Yeah, that's... maybe I can use this. I don't know, the packaging is kind of messed up. This is what that looks like. By the way, I just got a new camera and it has the option to flip the little video screen so I can see myself, and that's, if I'm looking over that way a lot, that's probably why, because I'm not used to this. Seeing myself. Okay, and then lastly, a high sensitive stylus pen. Which I also probably won't use because I'll probably lose it. I can't find my phone half the time. A little review here. I've got to say, based on Brian's video, I kind of expected the Gizmocrate website to ask you more questions based on, because like on the website when you sign up, they ask you a few questions about what type of devices you use so that the items that they give you are geared towards what you already have. But I kind of thought they would ask more specific questions because even the way that Bryan was describing it was that they would ask you your favorite color and stuff like that, which I guess wasn't true. I don't know. But most of these things I don't think I would use on a regular basis. Mostly because, hold on, I'll show you what phone I have. Like, I have this Samsung and it's like a slide one. I don't know what it is, but I mean, I guess it's pretty old school. So I don't even think I, do I have Bluetooth on here? I don't know. Let's find out. Oh, I guess I do have Bluetooth. But do you need data to use Bluetooth? I'm afraid to turn it on. Like the most is the Sour Patch Kids, which I probably could have gotten at the dollar store. And maybe the solo charger that might be useful, but we'll see. If your stuff works, then great. Maybe, you know, I'll use it at the beginning for novelty's sake. The only complaints I have are it's missing the information card, because that would have helped me explain what this stuff is, and especially this thing, which I have no idea. But I'll wing it. Also, I had a heck of a time getting the box. It's definitely a good deal, I think, if you're in the United States. I, for example, am in Canada, and you have to pay extra shipping charges. So, oh, also, the card that you're supposed to get, it tells you the value of all the items so that you kind of see the value that you're getting for what you pay. And so, I have no idea what any of this stuff is worth. Otherwise, I would share that with you. But, and these reviews are supposed to be all positive, right? Because you're trying to get other people to sign up and try it out. But I don't think I would get another monthly subscription. I don't think it was worth it. On the website, they tell you that they're going to email you when the box is shipped out. And the date that it says it's supposed to get shipped out each month is different depending on where you're looking. So for example, the email that you're sent when you first subscribe tells you one date, the website tells you another date, the FAQ tells you another date, so it was all very confusing. But I went by the latest date that I read, but I didn't receive any emails, and I even waited like 5 days after that. And so I decided to email Gizmocrate asking what was going on and why I wasn't receiving a shipping email yet. Because what they do, you gotta be careful, is that if you're just getting a 1 month subscription, it will auto-renew at like the 28th of the month. And so this was like 5 days before it would auto-renew, right? And I haven't even received my first box yet. And so I thought to myself, there's no way that I want to buy another box when I haven't seen what's in the first one yet. So I emailed them saying, can you tell me what's going on with my box? And can you also make sure that my subscription doesn't auto-renew because I haven't seen the first one yet? Because that would just be silly to charge me for another one when I haven't looked at the first one yet. And lo and behold, you know, I didn't get a reply for like 5 days, and I just really hate calling. I know I should call, but I hate calling. I wish that they would just answer the emails. I think they give them plenty of time. I don't know. But they didn't reply, and then but, you know, they're right on top of the auto-renewal thing, so I get an email telling me that I've been charged with another one, and I got a little bit mad, and so I emailed them back again saying I want a refund immediately, and, you know, where's my box, and then they replied because they could tell I was getting agitated. So I guess you gotta get mad at them to get customer service. Yeah, but luckily they did refund my money right away. I was worried that would be an issue too. And they explained to me that the shipping was delayed because one of the items was delayed from the manufacturer or something like that. But I mean, really, you should probably tell the consumer if there's an issue, right? Or am I being unreasonable? I don't think so. Anyways, so those are the items. I mean, if you wanna give it a shot, then go for it. But I personally wouldn't recommend it. Maybe I'm just not as much of a gadgety person as I thought I was, but what the heck. It was an experience. We'll call it that.
So,
that is all. I'm going to eat these, and I will see you later. Bye!